product, the ICT website that we're going to be using, and I logged in. I'm going to click on Manage Resources. And I'm going to click a short name, or type a short name field for this. The first one I'm going to do is the CSV file that I exported. Type in the name, UTEP Earth, so you guys will be familiar with that data set. We worked with it a lot yesterday. And then I click the Create button. And I'm skipping the metadata section right now because we'll go over that in detail later. I'm going to go straight to source data to choose my file. I'm going to choose the UTEP Earth. CSV file, and I'm going to add it. So I know when I exported this from Excel, it was not specifically UTF-8, and you can see that it recognized that it was Mac Roman. If you click the I button next to character encoding, it shows you three of the encodings that are available. And so if it happened to be one of the others and it recognized it incorrectly, you could switch it. But it did recognize Mac Roman, so I'm going to leave that alone. It brought in my number of records, and I do happen to know that this data set has issues because I was expecting 99 records. It has 108. So at this point, I wouldn't want to publish this. I'd want to go back to my source file and figure out what was wrong with it. And we know from yesterday, this particular data set has those extra rows in it of data. So just wanted to show it to you this way so you could see why it's important to know your record count and how you can recognize when it gets imported into IPT if there might be an issue with it. You can go ahead and preview it still. And you can see columns and rows of data, and you can see how the data is coming into those fields. So, other than the fact that I have more records than I should, it looks pretty good. So, I'll go ahead and save it, because I don't want to lose my resource that I already started, and I would go back and then I would import it. So now I'm going to do the next one, which will be WFB zebras. I didn't know I was picking so many birds. I did that for town. So the resource has started, and I'm going to choose file. This time, I'm going to go ahead and choose the WFEZ.DWC2.zip file. I know that there is a CSV file within the zip file, and I also know this is a rather large file. So I definitely want to load it with the zip. Now I see it's taking a little bit longer. See the percentage of showing in the lower left corner. How big is this data set, John?
Uh-huh. 103 okay. Megabytes.
Okay. 189,000 records. And I had saved it as UTF-8, so it did come in that way. Preview the data. You can check it out and oh, my date last month doesn't look great, so I must have done something with my export. Dates are one of the hardest things to get out of your system in the right format. See if I got collection data right. So again, after seeing this, I would go back and modify my data set, export it again, trying to get the correct formats. Okay, that's the end of this part.
Point out the information, the summary information about having that project.
Right here. So after you come back to your manage resource screen, you see the file name, you see how many megabytes the file size was, your number of records, and how many columns of data. So that's your number of fields. Occasionally, if you do have that issue with extra row numbers, when you go to publish, it'll tell you how many records may not have met the correct number of columns that you uploaded. And so that's another indicator that you would know that something was off with your data. And we could come back in here and edit if we needed to. There is another option for connecting to a database source directly, and you can write SQL statements in here and connect to a database. I'm not sure, was there anybody in here that would do that? Connect to MySQL or Oracle or a Microsoft SQL Server? Okay. If anybody decides they want to see that tomorrow, just let me know. I've got several examples from people that we host that I could show. Okay, Kyle suggested that I show you an export from Google Refine to bring that in. So what I'll do is I know that WSEZ, actually I don't want to bring that one in, it's too many. Bring the UTEP one in, and that we fixed from the other day. So this one, I know we worked on it the other day, and it's got institution code, we've got an occurrence ID, a collection code. I showed you this yesterday where you can edit cells and transform them with the common transform to date. So I simply fixed that one. We have some of the extra fields that I had added. And we're going to export. Choose comma separated value. And I'm going to show you what happens if you upload a file that has a different name. So this one is utep-csv.csv. When I open that one and add it, back the correct number of records for me. So no issues there. And when I preview the date column, it's in the correct format. It recognizes it was UTF-8. So I'll click save. And now it shows me that I have two files here. So I definitely don't want to keep both files, because if I were to publish with both files, it would duplicate my record now. Not duplicate it exactly, but that came together. So I'm going to go back into the first one. Name named exactly the same. When I added it, it would have told